Well, a very good evening. Welcome to this live streaming from the digital platforms of the Tribune. I am Rohit Bhan. The BJP, JJP government in Haryana has survived the no confidence motion, which was brought by the opposition Congress over the farmers' agitation. The Congress had brought in this motion some few days back, and today it was put to vote, and that has been defeated. 55 MLAs voting against this motion and 32 in favor. I'm joined by my senior colleague Pradeep Sharma from the Haryana Bureau. So first tell us, was it on expected lines, the motion getting defeated?
Yeah, Rohit, it was very well on the expected lines, because as of now the arithmetic said that 55 would support the government and 32, because Congress has a total strength of 30, and two independent MLAs have already voiced their concern about the farms bill and decided to vote against the government. Right. So that was on the expected line.
Right. And also take us through what happened during the course of the day. The Chief Minister's address, Mr. Kuhuda also speaking. First, what did the Chief Minister say in response to this motion?
In fact, Chief Minister, a very interesting thing to say, that he had dared the opposition to bring the no confidence motion every 6 months, because that would give the government a platform to show its achievements. Right. So the motion was on the farm bills, but the discussion veered around certain other issues like failure of the government, then scam during the Huda. It was basically allegations and counter allegations, like we witnessed during the governor's address. This was the repeat of the governor's discussion. Right. So the farm bill were certainly at the center stage, but the issues, other issues also came up for discussion.
So what did the Congress achieve out of this no trust motion, Pradeep? It was expected to be defeated. So what did what was the Congress's aim basically by bringing this?
I think the Congress didn't achieve much. Right. On the other hand, it gave the Treasury benches, the ruling BJP and the JJP leaders, to dig out Huda's past. Right. And there were several scams during Huda's, because agriculture and land acquisition are Huda's Achilles heels. Huda, because there have been several scams, a series of scams in which, in a couple of scams, Huda has been charge sheeted also. So it gave the ruling party an opportunity to hit back at the Congress, that look, that we have done this thing for the farm, right, farm economy, and during your time there was a series of scams. Right. So it was basically a ploy to embarrass the government. But in that, the Congress has only achieved partially what were the stated objective here.
And also there have been some independents, also MLAs from within the JJP, who've been very critical of the government's handling and over the farmers' agitation. Were those MLAs, like Mr. Bubbly, were they in the list of speakers today?
JJP very smartly gave the list of even three MLAs, including the Deputy Chief Minister and one minister. Right. And none of the three vocal MLAs, two spoke against the farms laws yesterday, and one Mr. Devinder Singh Bubbly, the MLA from Tohana, who is a former congressman. Right. They were not in the list of speakers today. So in fact, that was a very clear ploy on the part of the JJP to keep the vocal MLAs away from the discussion. But having said that, now I think the rumbling will start in the JJP, because Bubbly has already set the ball rolling yesterday. Right. So there were a lot of activity in his home constituency, Tohana, with his brothers and other very active today. So now in the days to come, we'll have to watch out for the JJP.
He apparently threatened to resign also in the house when he was stopped from speaking or something.
That is his old, if my electorate wants me, I will resign, that my single vote against the government won't make much a difference. Because right. Anyway, the anti-defection law is very clear. Right. So you can't vote against the party bill.
So for Mr. Khattar's government, now since this they have survived this no confidence motion. Looking ahead, I believe in the House also they spoke in terms of constituting a committee for the APMC Act. What would that committee do?
Well, I think these are the central laws. There's hardly anything that the committee can do. That is basically a ploy to mollify the opposition and buy some time. Right. Until unless the farmers' agitation dies, because Haryana is the epicenter, both Tikri border and the Singhu border, they are the epicenter of the farmers agitation. Basically, government is trying to buy time till an amicable solution is found or the farmers agitation ends. So that is basically a delaying tactics.
Okay, so this round seems to have gone to Mr. Khattar's favor.
Yeah, of course, because numbers were anyway in favor of the government. So the Congress wanted to achieve something, but it has partially achieved its objective. So the nothing that the Congress can, because there was no threat to the government as such, despite human dissenting voices within the JJP or a couple of human independent animal who've been voicing their concerns repeatedly time and again.
But interesting would be to watch out for the JJP.
JJP, because JJP, you see, most of its MLAs, besides Dushyant and his mother, they are from the other parties, primarily from the Congress. So they are not basically from their parent party IND. They are either from the Congress or maybe some one or two are from the BJP. So as such, because they've been very vocal. Ram Kumar Gautam, not MLA, have been very vocal. This Bubbly has been very vocal. And then Jogiram Sehag, another MLA from Barwala, he's very vocal. In fact, he relinquished the chairmanship of a board in protesting against the farmers. So these three MLAs are to be watched in the days to come.
Thank you so much, Pradeep, for those details. So there you have this round apparently seems to have gone to the Chief Minister, Mr. Manohar Lal Khattar. But now it remains to see, as Pradeep mentioned, that the rumblings within the JJP, the Jananayak Janata Party, how it pans out in the next few days or months, that's something remains to be seen. For the time being, Chief Minister seems to have bought some time till there could be some resolution of the continuing deadlock between the farmers and the union government. We'll provide you all the details on stories related to farmers' agitation. You can also log on to our website, tribuneindia.com, and also follow us on our other social media platforms like Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Meanwhile, thanks for watching.